Winning Sixth Man of the Year was just the beginning for James Harden. His innovative offensive style has defined the modern era as a three-point shooter and a force driving the lane. A three-time scoring champ and an MVP, the Beard appeared in one NBA Finals and has his eye on more.
Spoke to Mom about the facial hair. Are you going to keep it?
Maybe for a few more weeks, but I'll take that into consideration.
Crossover, pulls back, shot clock at two, puts it up, puts it in!
Oh my goodness, Beard the Beard.
Honestly, this is going to be a wild statement, the most underrated player of our generation. Can you name another player that bet on himself, took over a team from a six man, and absolutely put that organization on his back, and at this point, he could play point guard and lead the league in assists. He could play point guard or two and lead the league in points. I don't know very many players ever that can switch that on and off the way he can. He's unstoppable when it comes to scoring, and that's just a fact.
A lot of people say, ooh. There are three or four people on this planet who can make that shot right now, and James Harden happens to be one of them.
You don't know what Harden's gonna do. Will he pull up and shoot the three?
Oh!
Oh!
We traded for James very late in training camp. And so he comes in and, you know, we had played against him when he was at OKC. He was still a young player. So he wasn't the James Harden that he is today. But he got in there and I'll tell you, he made some his vision was elite. I mean, he made it some passes and he made some things happen that first day of practice. I went like, man, I just didn't think this guy had this type of vision for the game. He made passes to far corners and around the court. When you've been around the game as long as I have, you watch guys and all of a sudden, you know, he'll be driving left and just throw a dart to the far corner. You're like, the hell did you see that? Like, I mean, that, you know, he did stuff like that. That's when I went like, because I knew he could score. I knew he was very clever at getting fouled and very good at drawing fouls. But his passing was really something that I literally looked at and went like, wow.
You add me into this top 75 greatest of all time list.
Ever?
Yeah.
It's coming from where I come from, man, just to even be in the NBA. And that was like a far-fetched dream. And then not just making it, but sustaining. This game has given me so much, man. It's a beautiful thing. So I'm just blessed to be a part of that, you know, that list, and it don't stop.
James Harden is someone who can score in his sleep. He's a little stronger than you think he is, a little quicker than you think he is. He can shoot a little better than you think he is. His basketball IQ is underrated to me. That's the one thing where it's like, people don't give him credit for how intelligent he is. His basketball intelligence is why he's one of the best players ever. We've seen him shatter scoring records. We've seen him write his own record, so to speak. And he does it in such a way with that step back and the handle and, you know, the craftiness, the shiftiness. That's the style all his own.
Oh, he fell down.
Under two to play. Harden, step back, puts up the three, got hit, shot's good, and one!
He just looked at the crowd and said, wow.
I thought in high school he was a pro. He had a professional game in high school. He had a professional makeup. He had a professional candor. He had a professional swag, right? And people say, like, back then that he had an old man's game, right? Meaning that, you know, it didn't look like he was putting forth a lot of effort, but he was effective. And so when you watch the trajectory, you know, of his career, every level he's dominated, but because he makes it look so easy.
It's become a skill that he's developed. He knows how to get fouled. He knows how to make it look like he gets fouled.
Oh, and there's James Harden with these incredible numbers. Oh, and there's James Harden, you know, the third, fourth pick in the draft, right? And so you start to see his value as he starts blossoming, you know what I mean, into his pro career.
There's a three, and that makes Harden number three all time in three-point shooting, passing Reggie Miller. Harden there with a dance! That move is illegal in most every state except in Texas.
Man, I was a huge fan of James Harden, watching him tear up my Arizona Wildcats when he was at ASU. So, you know, I was real fond of his game. And then becoming his teammate, I really got to see it up close and personal. Like, his basketball IQ, his ability to make the guys around him better are things that get overlooked because he's so good with the ball in his hands and he's so good individually as a one-on-one player. he easily could have 2 to 3 MVPs. And one of the years I played with him probably was one of his best years, and he didn't win the MVP, but he took us to the Western Conference Finals the year Golden State won their first championship.
Yeah, I got to make sure I'm great, I'm healthy, I'm in a place where I can be the best James Harden I can be on the court. So my job is to come out there and help the entire team win the championship.
James Harden has led the NBA in scoring 3 times. He's led the NBA in assists once. And particularly if you look at it through sort of a modern analytical lens, there's an argument to be made that he is one of the top 2 or 3 offensive players of all time.
No question about it, Matt. When you look at James Harden's career, he came in as a backup, coming off the bench, 6th man for OKC. And then when he moves on, the ball goes into his hands more, and he's proven that he can get to any spot on the floor. And he kind of changed the game and how the rules are about the game with the step-back move, and more importantly, living at the free throw line, arguably one of the best to ever do it.
He's also sort of created a mold for other players like him, and you've seen it around the NBA where players will identify a high-usage guy, give him the ball, let him run the offense. Somebody like Luka Doncic, for instance, owes a debt of gratitude to what James Harden did for this league.
Great question, Matt. Now young players out there understand if the ball's in your hand, you can attack the defense, not always look to score the basketball. Understanding when 2 people are on you, somebody's open. So we haven't seen somebody in a long time like James Harden score 40 points and get 15 assists in the same game. That's why you appreciate what James Harden brought to the game for the NBA.
And it's interesting, again, in the context of the modern game, nobody's been able to figure out how to defend him.
How to defend him, and like I said earlier, Matt, when you're in the ISO situation, which most NBA fans love to watch, he has figured out how to get to my spot, how to use the pump fake, and once again, live at the free throw line and attack the defense.
Not only an NBA MVP, but he's finished in the top 3 4 other times.